What up? It's your girl Crush back with another episode of Chatty Patty Fridays on Podcast Crush. Yay! Woo! Now today, y'all, today. Oh my God, y'all. I can't even hardly stand in this seat, y'all. Because today, y'all, oh my God, we're going to be getting into Drake and Kendrick Lamar. Drake versus Kendrick Lamar. The push-ups versus Euphoria. That's what this is about. I'm going to dig a little bit into what happened in the past, what's happening in the present right now, like right now, and what's to come coming up. What, like, I'm going to be giving my predictions on what's to come, okay? For this beef between Drake and Kendrick, it's been brewing for a while now. And Kendrick has finally snapped on this nigga Drake, bro. I do be snap when I say snap. Like, this shit is out of fucking control. So make sure y'all stay tune in to the end of this video because you do not want to miss this. You do not want to miss this. Like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell. Let's go! So, the beef started with Control on Big Sean's song in 2013. This is how long this shit been going on. 11 years they've been back and forth. So, fast forward from Control to First Person Shooter with Drake and J. Cole. Drake dropped For All the Dogs. For All the Dogs, he had a song called First Person Shooter, where J. Cole mentioned the big three as Kendrick, Drake, and himself. Alright? But in the video, where in the song, J. Cole said he felt like Muhammad Ali. Basically saying he felt like he was the greatest. Although he was part of the big three, he felt like he was the greatest of the big three. Now, mind you, Drake, Cole, and Dot all say they're the greatest rapper of their time, or of all time, or the best rapper alive. Like, they all claim this, right? Sorry. So, of course, they knew when they said this, or they should have known when they said this, that Dot was coming. Dot was coming. Like, nobody is claiming no best rapper alive while Kendrick is alive. Like, it's not going to happen, right? So, from that, I know y'all seen when Cole apologized to Dot. That's because of what I'm about to tell y'all next. So, Metro Boomin and Future is also into it with Drake. And they dropped the album called We Don't Trust You. Okay? A whole album called We Don't Trust You. They say that whole project is about Drake. All those songs about Drake. That's why you hear The Weeknd, Rick Ross, Kendrick Lamar. Everybody got something to say about Drake ass. Okay? And we're going to get into that too once we start listening to Euphoria. So stay tuned because I'm going to review and go through all of the breakdown of Euphoria, okay? It's nuts. It's crazy. Like, you do not want to miss this. Like, I have broke this shit down for the last 2 days. This is all I've been doing is studying this song. And it's so much that he cracked on Drake ass that it's some shit I know a lot of people didn't even catch that I caught. Okay, especially the Joel Osteen line, like the 6 cent shit, like I had to get kind of deep, and I got it for y'all, so stay tuned. Okay, anyway, so fast forward from First Person Shooter to Like That, with Future and Metro Boomin with Kendrick Lamar, Like That, nigga, fuck the big three, nigga, it's just Big Me, nigga, boom. Okay, that's what Kendrick Lamar said, nigga, fuck the big three, nigga. It's just Big Me, nigga. It's just me. I'm the greatest, nigga, is what Kendrick Lamar said. And he said some other things in there, too. I'm going to leak all of these songs and some others for you guys to track this beef all the way back. I'm going to start all the way back from Control for First Person Shooter, Like That. And you guys can fill in all the disses and some other videos to explain all the rest to you. I might even do a part two and get deeper. Let me know in the comments if y'all want me to do a part two and dig a little deeper into this beast. Okay, so boom. Fast forward from first person shooter all the way to Like That with Metro Boomin and Future and Kendrick Lamar, which is a banger. That beat is fire, nigga. Like, ain't nobody fucking with that nigga Metro Boomin on them drums. That nigga Drake said, nigga, shut your whole ass up and make some drums, nigga. You ain't gotta fucking say it twice, because that nigga, yeah, okay? He did that shit on Like That, okay? So, boom. Fuck the big three. Nigga, it's just big me. Nigga, boom. All right, bam. So, then we fast forward to Drake Push Ups, okay? Let's dive into this. It's a lot to unpack. I had to go get my glasses, but let's go. Drake Push Ups, drop it, give me 50. He dissed every fucking body. He went in on Dot, Ross, Weeknd, Metro Boomin, and Future, and some NBA player. I think it's John Morant, if I'm not sure. I'm not clear. If I'm fucking up, let me know in the comments who's the NBA player that Drake is talking about, y'all. Mind you, this is a good diss by Drake. In no way, shape, or form am I saying that Drake is whack, because in no way, shape, or form is Drake whack. He's not. But it is some issues about his character, okay, and his nationality, all right? Now, Drake came hard with push-ups, but where he fucked up was when he did that goofy shit and dropped Taylor May using Pac and Snoop voices and AI, artificial intelligence. Some hated it, some said it was okay. To me personally, I feel like it was lame and it was disrespectful to Pac. You feel me? Like, he know that Kendrick Lamar is a diehard Pac fan. And he, like, Pac was like how Myron Golden is to me. He was a mentor to Kendrick Lamar in his work that he did. You feel me? And Kendrick Lamar is really, 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 I would say, sensitive when it comes to Tupac. Okay? So, I low-key feel like all these rappers is obsessed with Pac. Honestly, Drake is obsessed with Pac. He always trying to find some jewelry that Tupac on, using the AI. And it's other rappers, too, who always, like, it's always some with Pac. How many years later, Pac been gone? Like, what? Almost 30 years? And niggas is still, like, Pac, crazy. Like, which is what's up. Like, Pac was so beyond... Pac was so before his time and was so talented. Like, he gonna live forever, literally. Like, if you don't know about Tupac, any young kids watching this show, go and do your research and your homework on Tupac. Tupac is one of the greatest rappers of all time as well. All right. So, like, Drake, he went at Kendrick, but in Euphoria, Kendrick also warned Drake to keep friendly and to not lie on him. And also, Drake threw some threats out there, too, as well, said, nigga, don't make me jump on Demon Time, nigga. I know more shit about you. So, let's get into these lines, all right? The first shot he took at Dot was, your last one, Brick. You really ain't on shit. They make excuses for you because they hate to see me lit. Pull your contract because we got to see the split. The way you doing splits, bitch, your pants might split. Like, damn. I mean, your pants might rip. Like, damn. The way you doing splits, bitch, your pants might rip. Damn. So, Drake, that's him talking to Dot, saying that, you know, his contract is all and his money is all split up. From Top Dog, Interscope, Aftermath, you know, et cetera, et cetera. Like, you know, because Kendrick from the West Coast, so yeah, he was signed to Interscope, Aftermath, which makes sense. Dr. Dre, that makes sense. The biggest producer on the West Coast, only the biggest artist would be with the biggest producer, right? And do make it adds up, right? And so then this nigga Drake is questioning like what these niggas is doing. So in the song Push Ups, Drop It, Give Me 50, he say, what the fuck is this? A 20 verse one nigga? What's a prince to a king? He a son, nigga. Get my love in your city that then you get my love in the city that you from, nigga. Metro, shut your whole ass up and make some drums, nigga. Wait a minute, Drake. He snapped. And so, like, this is, to me, I can see why Kendrick went so hard, because these are aggressive. This is aggressive to me. This is for sure aggressive rap. This is aggressive. This is aggressive bars. Like, and he ain't even rapping. Like, if we know something about Drake, we know Drake can rap. But we don't know shit else about Drake. And he ain't even rapping on this song to me. To me, these was like shots fired, warning shots. Bye bye, bitch. Quit playing with me. But with the way Dot came, I feel like Dot said, nigga, bye 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 bye, bitch. Shots fired. You been warned, bitch. So, this is the best. Y'all, listen, please. Stay tuned. Y'all do not want to miss this breakdown of Euphoria. I'm about to play it right here on Podcast Crush. So, another disrespectful line he said to this nigga Kendrick. Ty say, drop your little midget ass, better fucking drop it, give it. Drop it, give me 50. So, Top Dog, I think it's the label that he was signed to. Top Dog signed to Interscope Aftermath. So this nigga Drake goes back in on Kendrick by saying, Maroon 5 need a verse. You better make it witty. Then we need a verse for the Swifties. Top say, drop, you better drop and give him 50. So he trying to play on the fact how Kendrick say that they not the same. They two different type of artists. But Drake like, nigga, you did a song with Maroon 5 and Taylor Swift. Nigga, we ain't that much different. Nigga, you pop too. What the fuck is you talking about? Like, nigga, you sound crazy, is what Drake trying to say to Kendrick. Because, you know, Kendrick consider himself to be a conscious rapper. All right? So, yeah. And so Drake disrespects this man again and says, How the fuck you big stepping in a size 7 man's? This nigga, how the fuck you big stepping with a size 7 man's on, nigga? Call that nigga Littlefoot's child. Oh my God, dog. This nigga Drake, man. This nigga Drake, he went hard. Listen, no hate for me. No hate for me. Drake went hard. He ain't go harder than Kendrick. But this was enough to make that nigga snap like he did, as you can see. He said, pimp squeak, pipe down. You ain't in no big three. SZA got you wiped down. Travis got you wiped down. Just like the label, boy, you in the scope right now. And you gonna feel the aftermath of what I write down. Dang, he went for the label. And he went for the labels and the juggler. Told that nigga, pimp squeak, pipe down. You ain't part of the big three. Nigga, SZA got you wiped down. Travis got you wiped down. Woo! He said, Savage got you wiped down. Just like your label, boy, you in the scope right now. Ooh! Damn, Drake. I don't do one no ghost bars. That was hard. And then he went in on Ross and said, this nigga Drake went in on Ross. I might take your latest girl and cuff her like I'm Ricky. Can't believe he jumping in. I can't believe he jumping in. This nigga turning 50. Every song that made it on the chart came from Drizzy. Spend that little check. Nigga, spend that little check. You gotta stay up on my business. Damn! Y'all know Rick Ross been calling that boy white boy, but I think I know why. Because they said Crody means Brody in the crypt, but I'm thinking that they talk about Crochet. Protea. Look it up. Look it up. All right. So yeah, Ross and Drake. Yeah, they not cool like that. Ain't no more Maybach Music / OVO. Ain't no OVO Maybach Music. Ain't no more of that. Ain't no more of that. Ross unfriended Drake and everything. Like, these niggas is on Drake's scalp, dog. And so then Drake went in on The Weeknd. Y'all know The Weeknd, the singer of The Weeknd, loving the crew. Cause we're loving the crew. Loving the crew. Yeah. The Weeknd, that was The Weeknd song he gave to Drake for Take Care. So the reason why The Weeknd and Drake is beefing is because The Weeknd was supposed to sign with OVO back before he signed to Republic, but he didn't. He did give Drake half of his project for Take Care, which were all of those bops with The Weeknd on it on Take Care is from The Weeknd. Okay, they were saying that Drake was kind of sour with The Weeknd after he didn't sign the OVO and went with Republic. But how could you be mad? I don't feel like The Weeknd would have had the same success had he went with OVO. I'm just keeping it a bean. You feel me? Like, The Weeknd did what was best for his career, what he thought was best for him, and I'm not mad at that. Drake don't need to be mad at that either. That's whole shit. Like, how you mad at this man? Like, make it make sense. Please make it make sense. Okay? So, he took a shot at The Weeknd on push-ups, and this is what he said. Cash blowing, able bread, out here tricking. Shit we do for bitches, he doing for niggas. Jets, whips, chains, wicked. Spinning like you trying to fuck, boy, you sick. So basically, Abel is The Weeknd. That's his real name. What he's saying is that The Weeknd's manager is blowing his money on niggas, saying this nigga is doing shit that they do for bitches. He doing this shit for niggas with The Weeknd money, child. This shit is crazy, y'all. Like it be so much shit going on behind the scenes that we don't know. And if y'all, just imagine, this is some light shit. This shit light as hell compared to what really be going on behind the scenes. And so this nigga Drake said at the end of push-ups, "This ain't even everything I know. Don't wake the demon up. Drop it, give me 50. All you fuck niggas teaming up." So basically, Drake saying, y'all niggas think this shit sweet. Y'all niggas think I'm pussy, but nigga, I know way more shit than what the fuck y'all think I know. And nigga, y'all come up here with this goofy shit, nigga, everybody gonna know what the fuck going on, nigga. That's what the fuck Drake saying, nigga. Like, what? Like, nigga, ain't shit sweet over here, nigga. Y'all think I don't know shit about what the fuck y'all be going on. Because Kendrick, he have a real quiet, low-key life. Like, you don't, he don't be in the mix. Like, he talked about him cheating on his wife on his last album, Mr. Manor. Mr. Morale. I'm sorry. And, that's how people knew what happened. Otherwise, I don't feel like a lot of people knew. Maybe a few people in the industry knew. But I don't feel like it was like something like out to the public knowledge and shit like that. Because Kendrick Lamar keep his life real low key and real fucking quiet, man. So now, here is what we all been waiting for. Even me, because I love this song. I've been listening to it ever since it dropped. And I am excited to do this review right here on Podcast Crush with y'all. Let's get it. Woo, shit, my man said this is my
Euphoria. Them superpowers get neutralized. I can only watch in silence. The famous actor we once knew is looking paranoid and now spiraling. You move just like a degenerate. Every antic is feeling distasteful. I calculate you, now it's calculated. I can even predict your angles. Fabricating stories on the family front, cause you hurt Mr. Morale. A pathetic master manipulator. I can smell the tails on you now. You're not a rap artist.
So basically, in this first part of the song, he took shots. Bah, 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 bah. just made myself choke. He took shots at Drake's character. All that whole beginning part where he's talking about how Drake is an actor who is spiraling out of control. He's, at this point, how everybody talk about how, you know, prepared and calculated Drake is. He's saying, nigga, I ain't even got to calculate because I can already know what you gonna do next, okay? At this part of the song, he's calling Drake a pathetic manipulator and habitual liar. Yes.
I'm modest with the hopes of being accepted. Tommy Hilfiger stood out, but FUBU never had been your collection. I make music that electrify him. You make music that pacify him. I can double down on that line, but spray you this time. This random acts of kindness. I know you're a mask manipulator and a habitual liar too. But don't tell no lie about me.
And I won't tell the truth about you. So, he say he make music that electrify the people, that sparks something in their minds, and that Drake make music to pacify people. Now, some people is saying that pacify bar is due to Drake dealing with underage girls, allegedly. I don't know how true this is. And then some say is that he just make mediocre music to pacify his fans. This is what the people are saying that bar could mean. And like I said, he tells Drake, I know that you're a pathetic master manipulator and habitual liar, but don't lie on me and I won't tell the truth on you. Basically, that's what that last part summed. Oh my God, y'all. This is so exciting. This is like the best rap battle we had in a long time. In a long, long time. Because the girls ain't really give it to us like we needed. Because Megan didn't come back after Bigfoot. You feel me? Which, no disrespect to my baby. I'm just saying, the girls don't be giving up the rap, giving it up with the rap beef like the guys do. And I ain't gonna lie, this song is really fucking good. Let's get into the rest of it. Shoo. 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 Hey, This is the intro, y'all. Bro, so Drake said, what Drake say? I'm sorry, y'all. That was from my notes from Dot. But no, Drake said, this ain't even everything I know. Don't wake the demon up. This ain't even everything I know, nigga. Don't wake the demon up, nigga. That's what Drake said. So, Dot said, everybody be on demon time till they get chipped by a throwaway. Like, nigga, don't think that something can't happen to you. You feel me? He said that Drake had his friends sell their souls, child.
I hate when I rap or talk about guns, then somebody die, they turn into nuns, then I hop online, like pray for my city, he faking for likes and digital hugs. His daddy a killer, he wanna be junior, they must have forgot the shit that they done, the mention must run in his family, but then it gets shaky. I park your son, the first time I shut me Drake down.
Hey, if anybody on this bitch into bars, Let's break down these bars. He say he hate talking about or rapping about guns, cause then somebody in the hood gets shot, and then they start acting like a nun, asking for prayers for their city. Whole time these niggas trying to be like they daddies out here gun toting and forget what's going on. He say the Mitchell must run in a family. He say, but if shit gets shaky, meaning if niggas won't smoke, park his son. Y'all get it? Parkinson's, the shaking syndrome disease, Parkinson's. He said if shit gets shaky, I'll park his son. That's fire. That's fire. Like, come on, y'all. Like, stop playing with dogs. Stop playing with that.
Tell me the aim is this way. I didn't point down enough today. I should have learned from those mistakes. Somebody had told me that you got a ring from God. I'm ready to double the wage. I'd rather do that than let a Canadian nigga make pot turn in his grave. Cut the finish. You got shit twisted. What is it, the brains? I heard your feelings. You don't look for me no more. Okay. There's
left. This nigga does nothing, bro! This nigga say, I heard you got a ring. I'm willing to double the wage. I'd rather do that than let a Canadian nigga make pot turn in his grave, nigga! Put some respect on that boy fucking name. Put some respect on that nigga dot name, man. Period. Period. So that's referring to a ring that Drake recently got that was designed by Tupac. Excuse me. They didn't say how much he paid for it, but whatever he paid for it, Dot said he willing to pay double to get that bitch. Because he don't want Drake to have it. Because he don't deserve it, basically, is what Dot's saying.
Kissing and hugging on stage. I love her to death. And they ain't bars, I'll explain their phrase. It's not nobody can tell me. I don't wanna talk on no selling. You know I got language barriers. It's no accent you can sell me. You're cold and not you know I'm a selfish nigga. The crown is heavy. I pray they my real friends. If not, I'm YNW Melly. Shit that for real for your mind every the beef. Yeah, fuck all that pushing pee.
Let me see you push a pee. Yo, he said, it's two ghosts on stage hugging, two, it's three ghosts left and two of them on stage hugging and kissing. I love them to death. And at eight bars, I explained that phrase. And then said, I pray to my real friends. If not, I'm YNW Melly. Y'all know who YNW Melly? Bow Bow, his two best friends. This nigga is goaded, bro. He is goaded. This nigga is really, he is the best rapper alive. I don't give a fuck. Nigga, I can't wait to hear Drake responds, bro. Oh, and then he spoke on how Drake disrespects Pharrell. That nigga said, nigga, I don't like how you trying to pop it to Pharrell, nigga. I inherit that one too. I eat that one too, bro. What up? And he said, nigga, fuck all that pushing P. Let me see you push a T. Because we all know what Pusha T did when he told the world about Adonis when Drake didn't tell us. Oh, my God. This is so good.
Nigga, I'm pushing me. He's Terrence Thorne. I'm Terrence Crawford. Yeah, I'm whooping feet. We ain't gotta get personal. This a funny face. You should keep it that way. I know some shit about niggas that make gonna wanna look like a saint. This ain't been about critics, not about gimmicks, not about who the greatest. It's always been about love and hate. Now let me say
I'm the biggest hater.
I hate the way that you walk, the way that you talk. I hate the way that you dress. I hate the way that you sneak this. If I catch flight, it's gonna be direct. We hate the bitches you fuck, cause they confuse themselves with real women. Then notice I said,
what? That was a lot to unpack. I didn't forget I had to buy that nigga. I'm stuck on that nigga said. We hate the bitches you fuck. Cause they portray to be real women. So is he talking, are they trannies? Or are they just bitches who ain't on they shit? Is they not real women? They bitches and hoes are not women? Or is they trannies? Which one is it, Kendrick? I need you to tell us this. And then he went on to say that, I hate the way that you walked away to talk. I hate the way that you dress. He got that shit from The Breakfast Club with DMX when DMX was asked about Drake. DMX didn't care for Drake either. And he kind of ran it down about how he hated everything about the nigga. Like, this is so fucking good. Like, Kendrick, like I like the way he brought to the forefront everything that's already been being said about this nigga to show people, like, dog, this shit ain't just start. This ain't just start with us. This shit been going on. This is crazy. That's just me. I'm with the culture feeling. He said this with the culture feeling. Everybody. How many more black features till you finally feel that you're black enough? I like Drake with the melodies. I don't like Drake when he act tough. You gon' make a nigga bring back puff. Let me see a chuff. Crash song. Yeah, my first one, like my last one. This a classic. You don't have one. Let your core audience stomach that. Didn't tell them where you get your ass from. V12 is a fast one. Puff, puff, puff. Headshot for the year. You better walk around like Daft Punk. Bro, do me a favor, go Google Daft Punk and come back to the video. Boy, I swear to God. When I heard that line, I was like this. Oh, nigga. Niggas catching strays left and right. Oh, D, I guess. Some shit just cringe worthy. Ain't even gotta be deep, I guess. Still love when you see success. Everything with me is blessed. Keep making me dance, waving my hand. And it won't be no damn. Cause I ain't seen him yet. Matter of fact, I ain't even bleed him. Bro. He done called all Yachty. Like, how many people done called strays in this shit? Yachty done called a stray. YNW. Melly done called a stray. Like, niggas. Gunna done called a stray. Niggas is catching strays. But I feel like niggas catching strays, but he directed it to Drake, but niggas is catching strays. Like, this nigga. This nigga is too good. Like, do not get me wrong at all. Push Ups did what it was supposed to do. It brought the beast out this nigga. And this ain't even his best. But this is the beginning of what is, like, about to come from this. Like, y'all. This is overwhelming. When I see you stand my sexy brain, I believe you see two bad bitches. Damn! If you don't like women, it's real competition. You might pop ass with them. That's... Oh my God! This nigga just said, I believe when you stand next to sexy red, you see two bad bitches. I believe you already like women, nigga. You think that competition, you might pop ass with them. Ah! He said Drake gonna be doing a turn competition, dog. Oh. Why you doing like this? I can see you don't know nothing about that. Oh my, y'all, why is he calling Drake out for his parenting? I just spit. Y'all, why is he calling Drake out on his parenting? He said, nigga, y'all think I'm around here trying to dig up dirt on Drake? Bitch, I'm raising my baby. Nigga, waking him up, teaching him how to pray, giving him tools to live with day by day. Teaching them about truth and consider what God is saying, nigga. You don't know nothing about it. Oh my God, y'all. That nigga say, because that nigga Drake said, what's a 20 verse 1? What's a prince to a son? This nigga said, it ain't no 20 verse 1. It's a 1 verse 20 if I got to smack your ghostwriters. If I got to smack these niggas that's writing with you, nigga. Y'all, my heart is beating so fast. And I think we still got like over a minute to go with this song, bro. This shit is too good. It's just too good. Bro, y'all gotta be hip to Joel. What's his name? Hell Joel Osteen. Amstein. Hell Joel Amstein. So this is like a triple entendre. So Joel Osteen, y'all know that's like the pastor that was caught with somebody writing his sermons and caught using AI and also caught being sending impersonators to like events and shit. Hell Joel Osteen is old boy who played in the movie Artificial Intelligence, and he also played in the movie Sixth Sense. So you see how he like flipped that? Like, I don't know if I'm battling Joel Osteen, the fake impersonated Ghost Rider nigga, or the AI shit. This nigga Kendrick is a fucking genius, dog. Like, who even fucking thinks of this shit? Like, how did this nigga mind? How did this nigga brain? Oh my God. Listen to this shit. You don't know nothing about that. If I got smack niggas that right with you. Right with you. AI. Austin. So, y'all know. See, what he's saying, what he learned about all this shit is that the truth was Drake never liked them. You know what I'm saying? And probably because he was from the West Coast. But this Crotty shit, to me, in my opinion, is up for debate because I looked it up. I looked up two different things. I looked up Crotian. Crotian is a race of white people that look black. They got darker skin and brown eyes and dark hair. All right? Look it up. But when you look up Crody, C-R-O-D-I-E, that's supposed to be Brody, but with a C. The Crip gang use it instead of saying Brody. But I think they mean, because why is Rick Ross calling him white boy if it's Crody? I think he's saying Croty. Like the Crotians. Like, yeah, that's what I'm trying. Because why he saying he don't want him to say nigga and all that shit? Like, I don't know, y'all. Do y'all think it's some sneak shit with Drake race going on? Like, he trying to pass as black all the time? Because if y'all remember, like, if y'all go look back, Drake was pale than a bitch. He didn't used to have that much color and shit to his skin. I don't know. Oh, my God. Me and my... Yeah, homie,
niggas is dick riders. Tell them run to America to imitate heritage. They can't imitate this violence. What I learned is niggas don't like the West Coast. And I'm fine with it. I'll push the line with it. Pick a nigga off one at a time with it. We can be on a 3-hour time difference. Don't speak on the family, Crody. You can get deep in the family, Crody. Talk about me and my family, Crody. Someone go bleed in your family, Crody. Have me a new all king eating fried rice with a dip sauce and a blammy, Crody. Tell me your cheese and bomb.
That nigga is making fun of the fucking Canadian fucking accent and told that nigga where the fuck he could find him at, bro. He say, nigga, I'm here, nigga. Eating something with a blammy, nigga. Nigga, what? Come on. We could do this shit with the cameras on, bitch. Like, what's going on? Like, Kendrick really talking like he on that. Y'all think Kendrick really on that? I heard that them TDE niggas don't play, though. I heard them niggas is really on that. That's why a nigga top dog. You feel me? Like, and I never knew none of this shit till all this shit got started. Like, this shit is amazing to me, honestly, bro. I'm like, oh, this is the most entertaining shit that has happened in about 3, 4, 5, 6 years. I don't know.
Do this right now on the camera, Crody. Yeah, all we hoe niggas is dick riders. Tell them run to America to imitate heritage. They can't imitate this violence. What I learned is niggas don't like the West Coast. And I'm fine with it. I'll push the line with it. Pick a nigga off one at a time with it. We can be on a 3-hour time difference. Don't speak on the family, Crody. You can get deep in your family, Crody. Talk about me and my family, Crody. Someone go bleed in your family, Crody. Tell me a new all king eating fried rice with a dip sauce and a blammy, Crody. Tell me your cheese and bomb. We can do this right now on the camera, Crody. Hey, fuck y'all niggas, I'm trash y'all niggas. I only one finger and dump y'all niggas like, feel good, punk y'all niggas, they punk y'all niggas. Nobody never took my food. Whoever that's fucking with them, fuck you niggas and fuck the industry too. If you take it there, I'm taking it further. There's something you don't wanna do.
Shots fucking fire, and that nigga said, fuck everybody. If you working with him, fuck you. Fuck West, fuck Bad Boy as a staff label and as a motherfucker crew. That nigga said, fuck the whole industry, nigga! And that nigga said, if you take it there, I'ma take it further. That's something you don't wanna do. Oh, this shit, dog, Drake, like, what the fuck is Drake gonna say to this? What is Drake going to say? I wanna know. Like, they say Drake is dropping at midnight. Today is May 2nd, and they said Drake is dropping midnight May 3rd. I cannot fucking wait to see, like, how the fuck are you going to fucking respond to this? If Drake responds tonight, I will not be getting no sleep tonight. I'ma be up all fucking night. Oh God. This shit is crazy. So yeah. I don't know what's gonna happen. I'm just waiting on Drake's response. I don't know how he's gonna respond to that. That was the whole Euphoria breakdown from Crush perspective of what I think about it. Let me know in the comments what y'all think about it. Let me know if y'all feel like Drake could come back from this. Let me know if y'all think it was whack. Let me know what y'all think overall. Drop it down below in the comments. Like the channel. Subscribe to the channel. Just like the video. Hit the notification bell. Comment. Share. Do everything you need to do. Everything, all the information you need about me is in the description. And I'll be back next time. I might be doing a part two to this. Depending on if Drake drop tonight, we gonna see. And until next time, bye.